Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about the entomology's crop-wise pest classification. So I am going to cover the topic of pest of soybeans, and I am going to list out the insects which are present in soybean as usual for the other crops. So you can be able to see the list in the last of the video as well as in the playlist of our video. So let's move for the insect classification one by one. So the first one is brown leaf hopper, where it is a oocid species, and it is a vector of which broom disease in soybean. So, and the next one is sailor butterfly, where the scientific name is Nyptis jumba, as well as it is in the family of Nymphalidae. And the larva, which is said to be a green with the process on the sides of third, fourth segment, and as well as in the terminal segments, and it also used to have spines on the head. And adult, while seeing about them, it is used to have black wings with white spot is the identification of the adult, and it is a picture of the sailor moth. And the next one is pod fly. So while seeing about them, they used to have a dark brown incrustation on the pod wall, and even in the dry pods they used to have a showing of pinhead sized small holes, which is a symptom we can able to see the infestation of pod fly in the field, and we can able to see the shriveled stripped as well as partially eaten seeds in the pods. So while seeing about them, the immature stages of egg larva as well as pupa, which used to occur inside the pod. So the several infestation which used to occur in a single fall, larva usually consume seed consuming, which used to constrain its starch portion as well as embryo, so which make them not germinate as well as orals. They can be fully eaten, as you can able to show see in the picture, and they also even leave the trails of excreta, which runs which make the seed inedible. And the next one is ground leaf miner, where the scientific name is Aporima morisella, and the symptom of damage where they use to leave a small brown blotching on the leaves, so which indicates there is a leaf miner present in the soybeans. And later the stages, the leaf web which used to reflect together and feed on them, and remaining with the folds. So while in the several infestations, they used to show the burnt symptom in the soybean field from the distance. So it is the characteristic damage for identification of groundnut leaf miner. So while seeing about their biology, so the adult is said to be a small moth, and for its classification, there used to be a prominent white dot in front of the front margin of the wings, and the female which used to lay an eggs of around 150 to 200 eggs per female, and there is a have a egg period of around 2 to 3 days. And the young larva, which is said to be creamy yellow with a dark brown head, and also they have a 9 to 17 days larval period, and the pupa, which is said to be reddish brown, and pupates in leaf fold for 3 to 7 days. And the next one is the management of the soybean disease pest. So by planting a cowpea or groundnut as a trap crop, we can be able to manage the crop in the natural way, as well as crop rotation with the non-leguminous crops is advised in case of several recurring problems. And also we can be able to go for crop rotation with groundnut with soybean, and also with other leguminous crop should be avoided. And also collection and destruction of egg masses as well as early instar larva in the soybean is an effective one in the field. And we must need to use light trap at our 1 head per hectare for moss trapping, as well as monitoring of the insects. And also we can able to release biocontrol agents like Trichogramma chylonins at 50,000 per hectare. And also we can go for mulching with the straw rice, which can reduce the leaf miner incidence, as also increase the percentage of parasitin present in the field naturally. And we must need to conserve the biocontrol population species in the field level, so which reduce the pest incidence in the field. And so we can able to go for the insecticide spraying as a final one. We can able to use at the application at about 45 and 70 days after the planting. So the spraying of final pass 25 EC 2 ml or methyl dimethone 25 EC 1.6 ml or dimethoate 30 EC at 2 ml per liter of water is effective against all the insects we have listed in the soybeans. So some other insects we can able to see in soybean are Soroptera retura, Myrosphera species, Holotrichia consanguinea, Marica testis, and Bemisia tabaci, and Epoia saca. So these are the some other insects we can able to see in soybean, which are not a major ones. So I have given the lecture notes in description, and comment up the video and join us in the Instagram page. So if you like the video, like it and share it with your friends, and subscribe to BSC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up in next videos.